Hi, this is Kamu from Model Exam. This video is on the topic environmental issues. So let's move on to the topic. Introduction. So this chapter is on environmental issues. So what we are going to deal in this chapter is about the pollution. So before that, we have to know why this pollution is caused. So here, if you see, tremendous increase in the population is seen in the country. And this increase in population leads to an increase in demand for the basic needs like food, water, etc. And this increase in demand causes tremendous pressure on the natural resources. This pressure on the natural resources causes pollution in air, water, in soil and also other natural resources. So pollution and the ways to control it are being dealt in this chapter. Pollution. So the definition for pollution is the undesirable change in physical, chemical and biological characteristics of air, water, soil and other natural resources are termed to be pollution. So the agents that cause pollution are called as pollutants, and its harmfulness, that is the pollutant's harmfulness, depends on the concentration of it and depends on the amount that we consume it. So this is how the pollution acts on the natural resources and also in the organisms who are living in the earth. Air pollution. So here we are going to see about the effects of air pollutants. So in human, it causes respiratory problems. So when you are inhaling the polluted air, which contains a maximum number of microbes and other particles, it causes respiratory problems in human beings, and it also causes effects in plants also. So if you see, in plants, the effects of air pollutants are, it reduces the growth and yield. So because of that, plants also respire the air in the atmosphere. So because of consuming the polluted air, it causes reduction in the growth and the yield of the plant. Causes for air pollution. So here there are given some causes for air pollution. The first one is fossil fuel burning, so which causes more number of harmful gases to pass on the atmospheric air. And the next one is smoke from vehicles. As the transportation and automobile facilities has increased, this problem has creating the air pollution a lot. And the next one is emission from industrial plants. So development of industries is beneficial in one way, but it also causes defects in the environment. The main important causes is the air pollution. And the next one is smokestacks of thermal power plants, which comes under the industrial plants. And the next one is smelters. So the gases from these stations or plants also cause the air pollution. And then the release of these harmful gases such as nitrogen also makes harmful atmospheric air. Removal of air pollutants, part 1. So here we are going to discuss about how the air pollutants are removed from the industrial plants. So first method is a filtration. So filtration, before releasing the gases from industries, can reduce the amount of pollutants which are being released. One of the method used is electrostatic precipitator. So we will see about how the procedure in the electrostatic precipitator works to reduce the air pollution. The first thing, it is used to remove the particulate matter from the gases which are released from industries. This is present, that is, electrostatic precipitator is present in the exhaust of the thermal power plant, and a high voltage is applied through the electrodes which are present in the electrostatic precipitator. So from this high voltage, electrons are being released from this precipitator, and it is used in the removal of the particulate matter from the gases. So we will see how it is removed in the next slide. Removal of air pollutants, part 2. So here we are going to discuss about how the electrons are used in the removal of particulate matter. So the electrons is used in absorbing the dust particle which are present in the gases that are released from industries, and during precipitation it releases the dust particle, thus it is precipitated and the gases are released. And we have also another part which is called a scrubber, which is used in removing harmful gases. So thus the particulates and the harmful gases are also removed from the gas which is released from the industries. So this is how electrostatic precipitator works. Removal of air pollutants part 3. So this is a diagram which shows how the electrostatic precipitator works and the parts present in it. So as I said, high voltage is being supplied and a high voltage power supply is present and it is used in releasing the electrons that is negatively charged which shows the ion, and it also has the gas flow and the discharge wire. So the other amount of particles or substances are collected in the collection plate. So this is how an electrostatic precipitator looks. Removal of air pollutants part 4. So here we are going to see about the another major cause for air pollution, that is automobiles, and what are the measures we have to take to reduce the air pollution because of vehicles. And the first point is proper maintenance. So proper maintenance of vehicles will reduce the air pollution. And the next one is using of lead free petrol or diesel. And then by using catalytic converters in vehicles can also reduce the air pollution. So catalytic converters include materials like rhodium, and they reduce the poisonous gases by converting them into carbon dioxide and other gases and then release them. So that air pollution will also be reduced because of these poisonous gases. Noise pollution. So noise pollution is caused because of lot of noise or unwanted sounds in the environment. So the Air Act, that is Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in 1987, has decided that noise pollution also comes under air pollution, and this can be prevented by eliminating the unnecessary sounds in the environment. Noise pollution continued. So noise pollution is created when undesirable high level of sound is formed in the environment, and this can cause problems like physiological and psychological disorders, sleeplessness, altered breathing pattern, and it can also impair hearing ability. So when you hear a sound of about 150 decibels, it can impair your hearing ability. So these are the problems that are created because of noise pollution. Water pollution. So the next pollution we are going to discuss about is water. So this happens because of discharging waste particles or waste water in water bodies such as rivers, ponds, lakes, which are being used by lot of organisms. And an act which was established because of water pollution is Water Prevention and Control Pollution Act, which was amended in 1974. So this act was amended to maintain the cleanliness in water bodies. Domestic sewage and industrial effluents. So sewage water is something water which has the waste materials also. So this water, before treating or releasing into the water bodies, it must be treated. So this before disposal, treating these water will not create any pollution. But without the treating of this water, if you dispose it, it causes harmful for the organism which are living in water and the water which is consumed by human beings and also other plants. So it also consists of biodegradable waste and also other types of waste which cannot be degraded. Domestic sewage and industrial effluents part 2. So here we have to see about the problems that are created because of enrichments of nutrients. So we know that problems in which biodegradable waste is also present in the water. So presence of microorganism in sewage water is also there. So because of presence of biodegradable waste and the microorganisms, there are some reactions which are created. So biodegradable waste are being separated or converted into nutrients by the use of microorganism. So this creates an enrichment in the nutrients of the water. So it also changes the biological oxygen demand and it leads to increased production of algal bloom, which you call it as planktonic. And the other problems which are created are increase in production of problematic aquatic weed, which is also termed as terror of Bengal. So these are some problems which are created of the enrichment of nutrients in water. And we also have the disadvantage here that because of these plants are created, there will be changes in water, and that water is also not available for the use of human beings and other organisms. Biomagnification. So biomagnification is a problem is created when there is an increase in concentration of toxic substances at successive tropic levels, and this causes biomagnification, which causes increase in the DDT level in the aquatic food chain. So DDT level is harmful for the birds, and it causes problems like it causes disturbs the calcium metabolism and causes thinning of eggshells. So these are the problems which are created by biomagnification in the aquatic life cycle. Biomagnification continuum. So here it shows the aquatic life cycle and the biomagnification that causes reaction in the birds. So here if you see, it starts from water, produces zooplankton, small fish, large fish and fish eating birds. So fish eating birds are the last consumer. And if you see, the DDT level in water is 1, but the concentration of DDT gets increased till fish eating birds, and this causes problem in the fish eating birds. Like as I said, it causes problem in the calcium metabolism and it also causes thinning of eggshells. So this is how biomagnification reacts in birds. Eutrophication. So this is the natural aging of lake. This happens because of the enrichment of nutrients in an enormous level. And when the streams of lakes gets more amount of nutrients such as nitrogen, this happens. The plants and the other organisms that are growing in the lake areas grow enormously, and at a point of time they get piling up. So this causes natural aging of lake, which is also termed as eutrophication. Eutrophication continued. So as I said earlier, there will be enormous growth of plants and other organisms which are growing around the lake. So this makes the life to become impossible in that lake, and this is because of the enrichment of the nutrient in an enormous level. And this process of natural aging is called as the accelerated eutrophication. Solid waste part 1. So solid waste are disposed by the municipality and they are also called as municipal waste. And these are disposed from residential areas, hospitals, stores, schools, etc. And the waste includes plastics, food waste, glass, etc. And the methods which are used for reducing the volume of these wastes are burning, dumping underground and sanitary landfills. Solid waste. So there are 5 types of solid waste, and the first one is biodegradable waste. So biodegradable waste are easily disposed by dumping around underground, and this undergoes natural breakdown to give the fertility for the soil. And the next one is non-biodegradable. This cannot be degraded, and the only thing to avoid these kind of waste is using of biodegradable products instead of using non-biodegradable products. And the next one is recyclable waste. So these recyclable waste can be formed into another useful products. So we'll see about the remaining types in the next slide. Solid waste part 3. So we are going to see about the remaining types of solid waste, and the other one is hazardous. Hazardous waste may contain pathogen, and this waste should be treated before disposal of these waste. And the next type of waste is electronic waste, which are also called as e-waste. This can be buried in landfills and then incinerated. And these electronic waste can be recycled into useful products.